ASMR video. Thank all you guys from watching my videos and, you know, subscribing and commenting to all my videos. Today's video is going to be about something very serious that a lot of people more than normal go through on a daily basis, and that is depression. That is, you know, just being tired and all that stuff. So today's video is just going to be me about, you know, giving you good energy, giving you, just, you know, trying to talk to you about stuff like that. And I know you guys say y'all like my whisper voice, so I'm just gonna talk. So if you wanna, you know, if you like my whisper voice, you can, you know, relax just on me talking. But yeah, let's get into the video, you guys. Gang gang. All right, so I want to talk to you guys about depression. I know a lot of people say that they go through depression. I went through depression. It's kind of like a up and down type of thing. I just want to let you guys know that going through stuff like that, you guys can talk to somebody. You guys can, go about it the right way. I know a lot of people get depressed off of school, get depressed off of, you know, job, get depressed off of parents and stuff like that. But I feel like the best way to deal with depression is to talk to somebody, to be around people that really care about you. Because, you know, if y'all haven't noticed, if y'all not a fan of Mac Miller, he just passed lately. And that's the big topic that's going around. Obviously, it's been a big topic. But when you see artists like falling, it's plenty of artists, it's movie people, like it's hard for me to talk because so much stuff running through my mind and I'm trying to get it out. So this whole video is going to be about, you know, I might talk in circles or I might, you know, jump over words or whatever, but you know what, how I'm trying to say it, or, you know, just understand it. And if you like my voice, just relax. So basically, like I was saying, like Mac Miller, he just passed away off an overdose, and that's so big. Normal again, we take pills, we guys are not African American, you probably went through this too, but a lot of African Americans go through this as far as parents. And me being black, like, I remember just growing up and you just feel depressed and you just, you know, you want to talk to somebody, but your parents be like, shut up, like, ain't nothing wrong with you, go do this, go do that, ain't nothing wrong with you, like, and you start feeling like you're crazy. Started thinking about get off the couch, you drunkie, get off this car. But you don't know what's in their head. You don't know what they're going through. And I'm the type of person, I hold a lot of people accountable. The thing that makes me mad is when I know you know the right thing. You know what I mean? The people who try to take advantage, them the people that make me mad. Not the people who trauma, you know what I mean? Going through, like, in the military, people see people die, and when they come home, you know, they be traumatized. Psychiatrist every day to get their mind straight. But why we don't get that same, you know, treatment for people who's in a hood, people who's in these trailer parks, people that's, you know, that's disfranchised. I'm not even just talking about African Americans, because if you look at it, it's more poor, you know, white people is more poor. Black people, but that's because there's more white people in the world. So I'm not even talking about color, I'm not even talking about race. My thing is, why can't it have that same, you know, that same outlook on the people that live here? You got kids watching their parents die, car crashes, you got people getting shot every day, you got drive-bys, you got, you know, kids going into schools and shooting kids. You got all this stuff is happening in our generation. And it's crazy because, like, we gotta just sit back and tell each other, we'll get over it. It's like, people expect us to have thick skin and have thin skin at the same time. You want me to show compassion, but then you don't want to see my most vulnerable stage. So with this video, like, I don't want to just give all positive, you know what I mean? My last affirmation, if that's how you say affirmation video, I was just telling you, you're great. This video, I want you, like, this is a big issue. Like, I want people to really, really understand that you are great. If you're depressed, please talk to somebody. Like, even if you don't want to 50. I can't do this. You want to know when you can't do it? When it's over. When that toe tag is on there. I don't care how old you are. You can be 50. If you want to go play basketball, if you want to go skate, if you want to go do things, go do it. Why your age have to be, you know what I mean? Like, all this depression, all this stuff that's bringing us down now, it's just man-made. Because we're not happy with ourselves. We got to get happy with ourselves. Most of y'all need to look in the mirror like, I'm beautiful. I'm sexy. I'm fine. I don't care. Like, I don't care who says different. I know I am. And when you walk with your chin up high, people want to be around you. You know what I mean? You just have to understand that you are special. That you are the top goal for everybody. Stop saying you're fat. Stop saying you're skinny. Stuff like that started happening when cancer started coming and stuff like that. I was very depressed, you know. I told you guys already in a story, like, my cousin broke in the house and stole, like, my old shoe collection and all that stuff when I was in high school. Like, it's almost a couple months before I graduated. I was so depressed. Oh, my God. I'm not going to have all these shoes for the summer. I'm not going to look fly. I'm not going to be that guy. I'm not... Everybody gonna look at me and like, oh, you're not cool because you don't have a Jordan. I was really upset that I sat back like, why? I have a girlfriend. I just bought a car at the time. I'm in high school. I still got a job. Like, yeah, he took most of my materialistic stuff, but I got all that back and more. And it's just like, why does that matter? I'm sitting in my room depressed. Stomach in my butt, like I'm very, like, very depressed, and I had to sit back, like, nobody's gonna, just because you stole majority of my materialist stuff, you're not gonna take my joy, like, so every week, when I got paid, I bought some here, I bought some there, I still went out, still played basketball, still went out, have fun, still went out, and I noticed what I cared about, and what I thought people cared about, they didn't care about that. I'm thinking people gonna say, oh my God, he's not super fresh. He don't have on $100 jeans and, you know, $200 jerseys and shoes and stuff like that. Cause I, in my head, I wanna be that. That's how I see people looking at me. But in reality, people just wanna hang. They don't care that you got $300 shoes on. Like, they don't care. They just wanna hang. If they call you, we about to go do this. You got on. It's your mind that's making this judgment, and it's your mind that's playing tricks on you, and it's your mind that makes you go through all this stuff that you can literally just have a random cool life. Like, and with me, it was material stuff. I don't know what it may be for you guys, but I just seen the best of the best, you know, jump out of depression. The best of the best. I said the best of the best, the worst of the worst, jump out of the depression. I done seen people go from being homeless to seeing them driving cars or got their life together. Like, I seen stuff like that. Like, I done seen people where it's like, in my own family, where it's like, for years they was like, couldn't get it together until it was just, they met the right person or they met the right guy or, you know, they really worked or they went back to school. Got their life together. Now they are the top family member. And if you talk to them, they will never go back. They won't change a nothing because they need all the lessons. But conversation.